Everything's changed! Stop!
Oh no, they can't hear me. They'll die because of me.
One.
The number you have dialed does not exist.
Six?
The number you have dialed does not exist.
I already saw this symbol in several places. Looks like the previous owner didn't have a steady hand. I can use this to reach places beyond my reach. Not much to think about here. It's time to act. All I can see through the keyhole is that it's dark. What could the combination be? 666? Nope, that doesn't work. 123? Nope, that's not the combination. 000? Nope, that's not it. 625? Turns out the number to the ideological support center is not the right combination to this lock. I'll come back later. First off, this is a bucket handle, not a lockpick. Secondly, I'm not a burglar. I have no idea how to open a lock with a piece of wire.
Listen, comrade.
As effective as the political opposition in Matryoshka. For emergencies only, Station Master's cabin. Opening is forbidden. Station Master, driver, did you lose your key? Pay for the replacement. The cabinet's tied up with rope. Train driver's cabinet. Open at your own risk.
You don't need any cheats on cloth rules.
Oh, that's Miss Sesha with her kid. I hope at least they didn't get arrested. Oh, that's...
Listen, comrade, hear me though I'm
a key with a keychain shaped like a modern telephone.
Can show you how to live correctly when you're lost. There's no need to be crying. Press the space bar if you want to see some magic.
A key with a keychain shaped like a modern telephone.
Life isn't like typewriting.
A key with a...
Press the space bar and you're gonna see. Listen, comrade, living in Matryoshka isn't easy, but there is a way. You don't need any cheats or walkthroughs. Holding space bar will reveal the truth. Listen, comrade, hear me though I'm
what
tragic.
What could the...
The leader's words can show you how to live correctly.
Oh.
When you're lost, there's no need to be crying. Press the space bar.
Six. Two. Five.
This is Ideological Support, Senior Political Officer Brezhnev speaking. What is it, citizen?
Good day, officer.
What? I can't hear a damn thing. Ah. There's buzzing in the receiver like a train is coming. Louder, citizen, louder!
I'm at the train station and my train's leaving! Do you know how I can stop it?
This doesn't really fit into our main ideology, but there's an emergency cabinet at the station. Inside the cabinet, there should be a shortwave radio. Unless it's been stolen, you can use it to contact the train's crew.
Thank you! I can take it from here. I want to open a cabinet, and I don't know how to go about it.
I assume there's something ideologically very important inside.
I hope so too.
Then, it depends on how it's closed. If it's locked using a key, then you need to find the right key. If it's closed using, let's say, less permanent means, then you could try cutting through with something sharp.
Thank you, support officer. I have a problem with a combination lock. 3 digits.
Then you could have done what any sensible man would have done. Write down the combination somewhere nearby.
Maybe I did, in fact, do it.
I'll go check if I didn't leave it inside the other cabinet. I have a 3 digit.
Then you could have done. Write down the combination.
Maybe I did, in fact.
I'll go check if I didn't leave it inside the other cabinet. Thanks for now, officer. Goodbye.
Show you how to live correctly. When you're lost, there's no need to be crying. Press the space bar if you wanna see some magic. Even though life isn't like typewriting, press the space bar and you're gonna.
I hope it's not too late and I can still stop the train. I hope it's not.
Isn't he? See, but
I already saw this symbol in several places. I already saw the Titanic also sank to the sound of music. Does there always have to be someone playing during a tragedy?
Listen, comrade, hear me though.
Hello, sir. Hey! Can you hear me? I'm talking to you!
When you're deaf as a doorknob.
There's no need to be crying. Press the
hello?
Space bar.
Hey, can you hear me?
Magic,
I'm talking to you.
Life isn't like typewriting. Press the space bar.
Hello? Hey, I'm talking.
Listen, comrade.
Iron Curtain left. Socialist Soyuz right.
See, but there is
Iron Curtain left.
You don't need any cheats or walkthroughs. Holding space bar will reveal the truth.
They're rioting in the city now. Best they not see me.
Listen, comrade, hear me though I'm trapped.
I need to stop the train at all costs. It's a matter of life and death.
To live correctly. When you're lost, there's no need to be crying. Press the space bar if you want to see some magic, even though life isn't like. Listen, comrade, hear me though I'm tragic. The leader's words can show you how to live correctly.
It doesn't fit. This is the key to something else.
Press the space bar if you want to see some magic, even though life isn't like
I used to have better ideas as a child.
Press the space bar and
train driver's cabinet. Open at your own risk. Driver, did you lose your key? Pay for the replacement. For emergencies only. What could the combination? I'll come back.
Listen, comrade.
Dialing a number is very easy. I've done this many times before. You stick your finger into a number and turn it all the way clockwise. That's the number to the helpline. Some decent human being sits on the other end and helps out in difficult situations. H-I-N-T. That's a well-known Matryoshkin manufacturer of telecommunication devices. All in all, life is just about finding the right key. That's a solid key. I assume it must guard something important.
There's no need to be crying. press the space bar if you want to see some magic, even though
Vanya, life isn't you're dumb and stupid, but you know I love you, so if you forget the combination again, call me. M.
Listen, comrade,
yuck. Nothing worth seeing in there. Yuck. Nothing worth seeing in there.
Don't need any cheats or walkthroughs.
What could the
space
420? Ah, come on! I was sure that would work. That's not the right combination.
Listen, comrade, hear
me. I'll come back
later. The leader's words can show you how to live.
One. Two. Three.
The number you have done.
420.
Hello?
It's me, Vanya.
Oh, it's you. I didn't recognize you. Your voice sounds different. You were eating pickles again, weren't you?
Huh? No, I wasn't. Listen, this is very urgent. Mom?
Did you just call me your mom? Oh, you're drunk. You're at work, and you know that...
No. I didn't drink anything.
You were eating pickles after all. I know it! You're sleeping on the couch tonight.
Okay. But now I need the combination to my lock.
It's my birthday. I'm kidding. Don't worry, Vanya. I wouldn't do that to you. 777. Will you remember that? 3 sevens. And don't worry about the pickles. You'll feel better in the evening.
Thank you. Time's a-wasting, so...
A-wasting? You're talking funny! Vanya, you want to hear what I'll do to you in bed tonight, my furry Wolverine?
I'll call you later. Bye!
7 7 7
The number...
Isn't he? See, but there is a way.
And the correct combination.
Any cheats or walks.
777. Yes, it worked. A shortwave radio. Maybe I can contact the train driver. Story of my life.
The leader's words can show you how to live correctly when you're
army issued.
There's no need.
I saw the soldiers using these while I was driving through the army base.
If you want to see some magic, even though life isn't like typewriting, press the space bar and you're gonna see. Listen, comrade, living Matryoshka isn't easy, but
army issue. I saw the soldiers using these while I was driving through the army base. A radio without an antenna is like a waterfall. There's just noise. Bad reception.
Listen, comrade, hear me though I'm tragic.
Hello? Can anyone hear me?
Yes, comrade minister, sir.
Stop the train immediately!
But, comrade leader,
the situation has changed. Just a few days ago, I wouldn't have dreamt I'd be in a situation like this. I was a simple, young journalist back then, speaking at an international conference on the beautiful idea that is communism. The program I'm on is being broadcast live. I've heard the camera adds 10 pounds. I hope I don't look too imposing. The program I'm... Seven.
The number you have...
420. 420.
The number...
Five. 4 3 5 7
Hey, Mom.
Oh, Evan, Dad and I are just watching your conference.
Huh. Thanks, Mom.
If you need anything, just call us, okay? Good luck.
Bye.
The government keeps warning us that the enemy could be behind every corner. The Placeholder Brothers is the largest manufacturer of telephones in the world. The Placeholder Brothers is the... there's always plenty of time. That's Mr. So-and-so. He's the representative for the organizer of the head of the conference. Such an important man.
Good day, sir. Sorry, there's no entry here. The program is live.
And good day to you too, sir. While I appreciate your diligence, I am one of the speakers. I'm afraid I'm tardy, but I really must get inside. My speech is a glorious message that will enlighten and empower the good folks here.
Mr. Tardy, eh? I find it strange that you're afraid of your own name, but let me check the list.
No, I'm Tardy, not I'm Tardy. I'm Kowalski, Evan Kowalski, and I'm Tardy.
I'm sorry, I don't have a Mr. Kowalski or a Mr. Tardy on the list of speakers.
My speech fits the theme of the conference perfectly, since it's about communism and... But what? I must be on that list. Besides, I received an invitation from you.
Please, show it to me and we can clear all of this up.
I often wonder if people wittingly pack their briefs into a suitcase or their suits into a briefcase. I often wonder if people wittingly pack their briefs into a suitcase or their suits into a briefcase. A gramophone record. A folder with my speech for today. I've prepared a few slides for my presentation. Another gramophone record. The inside of my suit. The inside. I received the invitation this morning. For the first time in my life, someone has invited me. My slides for the presentation. Ugh, they're out of order since, as usual, I packed at the last minute. All those self-help books were such a waste of money. My speech. On the inferiority of bourgeois financial circles and the superiority of co-ownership by the people over the aforementioned system as exemplified by the Matryoshkin system. It rolls off the tongue beautifully. My speech. On the inferiority of bourgeois financial circles and the superiority of co-ownership by the people over the aforementioned system as exemplified by the Matryoshkin system. It rolls off the tongue beautifully. Damn, my whole speech is out of order. It's a good thing I wrote the speech on the back of an old comic book. All I need to do is piece it back together, and the speech will be ready.
I did it. And my teacher said I had cognitive issues.
A gramophone record with an anthem honoring the leader. A gramophone record with my favorite music. If I was getting paid for bad ideas, I'd have a big check. That made as much sense as Matryoshka's political system. The lady in reception said I should speak to the set manager before. I worked really hard on the speech. I won't give it to him. And the comment came out pretty well. Ooh, maybe I'll publish it one day. If I really pushed hard on it, it would still never work.
Hmm. That is indeed an invitation from us.
I told you.
Please accept my apologies. I was not informed there was a schedule change. I think I can squeeze you in during the coffee break. Please proceed to the stage.
Thank you.
Oh, and don't worry. While you're walking across the stage, our producer will definitely be playing commercials.
Huh. One of the speakers he'll present after me. Eric and I go a few conferences back. We just have slightly different viewpoints.
Sir, we're broadcasting live. Please sit down. Psst. Sir, we're... Psst. Psst. Sir.
Empty frame.
Psst. This is live.
The first speaker for today.
Please take your seats. I'd like to begin.
That's my spot.
Good morning. My name is Sean Redkick, and I represent the people of New Pork. Blood red socialism is pouring in across the borders of our world. We can't just stand idly by and watch as the enemies of freedom undo what our fathers fought for. We're not gonna watch men die face down in the muck in this bloody war on the peninsula so that the red invasion can secretly pour into our country. Communist evil. Communist evil.
It's like a real Santa Claus.
Thanks. Communist evil is like a real-life Santa Claus. Because it, well, it sneaks into our houses, doesn't it? And eats up all our cookies. Leaves us presents that we have to return because no one wants another pair of socks. Wait. That's not what communist evil does. What the hell am I saying? As we all know, enemy intelligence agents have infiltrated our country. They could even be here right now in our midst. Like, for example, right there. Or over there. Maybe you're one. Or your lovely wife there. Yeah, she could definitely be one. She's got that commie look, all right. Or you. You. Or you. Yes, you are a communist spy. A sleeper agent working in the shadows. And such agents,
They dream of apples.
Yes, exactly. They dream of apples, because an apple is a great symbol. Well, what it is a downright tasty snack. Well, they're delicious. They're good in pies. Fritters are good. Let's come back to this. I urge you all to stay vigilant, and even the smallest symptom, the barest hint of communist activity, should be reported to the authorities immediately. In closing, I would like to...
You probably wanted to recite a poem.
Heaven is red, violets are blue. I'm no longer listening to you. As I've just been informed by our producer, instead of our planned break, we will have an unplanned guest. It just so happens I have already had the displeasure of being smeared in his rag of a newspaper. I'm sure you'll all love him. Ladies and gentlemen, Evan Kowalski.
This is going to be interesting. And? How do you like the subject of my speech?
Eric, you know full well I don't share your...
I worked on it all weekend. All weekend. A man like you could learn a lot from it.
I don't think you should...
Fine, Evan. Be that way. I can see we aren't going to get anywhere.
Listen, Eric, let me school you on how sweet, sweet communism works. In fact, I'll give you a subscription to my great paper free of charge just to open your eyes.
You know, unlike your precious Matryoshka, we don't have a toilet paper shortage in the States, so I won't have any use for your paper.
You should read it more often. I write about you in it a lot.
Too bad none of it is true.
So you didn't have anything to do with thousands of retirees losing their life savings when you closed that bank?
Screw you! I don't give a crap about your newspaper or your retirees.
I'll gladly use that quote for the next issue. We've stopped bumping into each other lately.
See? Ever since you started smearing people in your newspaper...
Oh, I think you mean shining a blinding light on greedy, profiteering capitalist schemes.
No one wants to invite you anywhere anymore. It's sad. I heard you've been going to conferences about raising hamsters.
Ferrets! Not hamsters. Ferrets!
Don't kid yourself, Evan. Your daily worker monthly is in the crapper, deeper than a toilet brush, and doomed to be forgotten. Look, we've known each other a long time, and I just don't want to see you go down with the newspaper. But you will, if you don't get your nose out of other people's business.
You know what? I've already published 20 issues, and I'm just finishing the 21st.
How many people read it, anyway? Isn't it just you and your old man?
No. I mean... Sure, Dad does make up a sizable portion of my readership, but yep, that's neither here nor there. And besides, I have it on good authority that my mother reads it as well. Ha! Bet you feel pretty dumb about now, don't ya? Besides, people need to be informed on the only correct ideological stance.
I can't even tell if you're kidding or not.
Yeah, what about you? How do you even look at yourself in the mirror every morning? A man with your wealth and connections could do a lot of good for society.
You mean the ideological stance where I hand out my money to hippies in the park until we all have the same amount? It's a pipe dream. A false utopia. Open your eyes. There will always be the rich and the poor. Look, I'm rich, and let me tell you something. I wouldn't trade it for anything. I'm not giving away my money.
Eric, it's not about how much money you have. It's whether you feel like a good person or not.
My wife just hired a second pool boy, and my kids bully the best kids at the best schools. Yeah, I feel pretty good about it. Capitalists take matters into their own hands, while communists only use theirs to beg for charity.
Maybe communists give away money left and right, but bourgeoisie capitalists only give it in one direction, as you would know. You're the bourgeoisie capitalist.
Let it go already. You're just mincing words now.
This isn't over. Huh. One of the speakers... Huh. One of the speakers... I'm not sure if we've already...
You don't look like someone I'd normally see in my social circles.
Oh, so you're from circles. Is it nice there?
Right. I'm gonna assume you're from the plebs.
Huh. I'm from the working class of the cities and farms. Cities, to be exact.
A commoner, then. My time is expensive, and you are wasting it. I will give you 1,000 collars to return to whatever hole you've crawled out of.
You can't buy me, sir. After all, my ideas have no worth. I mean, they're priceless. That's what I meant.
This conversation is painful. I'd rather watch cement harden in a barrel that I'm sitting in. Will 5,000 guarantee I never see you again?
Money isn't everything, you know.
What? Now he makes jokes.
What did I say that was so funny?
Money is everything! Money can do everything!
You wouldn't happen to be, threatening me right now, would you?
Not directly. Commie garbage like yourself is worthless.
You just offered me 5,000 collars.
You should have taken it and returned to your slums, or wherever it is you nest.
Boy, you're a real dick.
I can afford to be.
And I think that a bourgeoisie capitalist pig like yourself could really benefit from my speech.
Did you call me a pig?
I was, speaking metaphorically. Pigs are actually quite clean animals.
Go away! Now!
I'll go. But first, I really think you should take one of these pamphlets. Communism and You, a Love Story. So you can really see just how wonderful it is in Matryoshka.
You are making a fool of yourself.
Hurry up. People are waiting for the speech to begin.
You know, I am prepared to give a slide presentation, and at the risk of you calling me Mr. Prepared, I couldn't help but notice that there's no canvas on the projector screen.
Mr. Kowalski, please understand you weren't on the list, so we didn't receive any instructions regarding your needs. Fortunately, we are professionals, so I have some canvas right here. There will be a break soon, and someone will install it.
No. No need for a break. I'll put it up myself in no time. The working class of the cities and farms isn't afraid of a little hard work.
As you wish. Here you go. The projector canvas.
I apologize for my ignorance, but I received the invitation only an hour ago.
Hmm. That's strange.
I wrote my speech in the taxi on the way over. So, I'm curious. Is this being broadcast to the entire world?
Well, Mr. Curious.
You know, that joke wasn't all that funny the first time.
We have the largest coverage in the world.
Do you think they're watching us in Matryoshka?
I doubt the authorities there allow their people to watch Western television. Or any, for that matter.
What are you talking about?
You should get back to the stage.
Okay, I'm going back to the stage. That's the door. It's also known as the only way out. It's not time to leave yet. Five, 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 four, three, five, seven.
Hello?
Hey, Mom.
What is it, Evan?
Mom, the stress is getting to me, and I forgot what I'm supposed to be doing.
Evan, we went over this so many times. You're supposed to show them slides of Matryoshka. Play the national anthem from the gramophone record, and then read the speech you worked so hard on.
Ugh, Right. Thanks. Never mind. I can't jam the slides into the holder since it's inside the projector. It's an empty slide holder. The screen's too high up. I can't reach it. The screen's too high. I still need to show the slides. I already did that. Thank you. Good morning, comrades, those in the studio and those watching at home. If you're thinking, where have I seen this dapper gentleman before, then perhaps you were in Booneysville several days ago at the HASP Manufacturers Conference, where I spoke about the responsibility of the working class in building a single-class society. A little about me. My name is Evan Kowalski, and I am the editor-in-chief of the Daily Worker Monthly. By the way, I highly recommend buying a subscription. I have come here today, quite unexpectedly, with a very important, exciting ideological message. Communism is good. In fact, communism is the best.
Boo!
Boo!
There's no room in our country for communism. Shut your commie mouth, Evan.
Get lost!
Now, gentlemen, there's no need to get angry. Are you telling our viewers that poor people shouldn't have more money? Do you hate the poor? Are you against the idea that every human being is equally important and entitled to a fair chance? Are we not all humanitarians?
I won't be part of this farce.
And there, you see? He runs away using his costly running shoes. Do the poor not deserve to run? I wonder if one of my other colleagues will engage me in a debate. I'm interested to see how they will claim that education, culture, and industry is not in our common national good, and how every citizen should not have the same equal rights to reap their benefits?
Enough!
Ha! See? That's what I thought. No one's brave enough for such a challenging discussion. Okay, then. Let's move on to the powerful beacon that is beautiful Matryoshka. Located just behind the Iron Curtain between the Capitalist Union and the Socialist Alliance.
Boo! Get off the stage!
Matryoshka serves as a shining example of communism done right.
Get off the stage, commie!
Boo!
All glory and honor belongs to the leader who infallibly and confidently leads his nation towards a bright future.
Boo!
Enough!
Get out of here before I burn the building down!
I'm picking up on a little tension in the room, so how about a joke? What would we have in the States if we didn't have capitalism? Everything!
I'm at the meeting of the party. Make it quick.
Glory to Matryoshka, comrade leader.
Ah, Major Orlova. How's your vacation at Uncle Sam's?
More fruitful than ever. Please turn on the capitalist channel, comrade leader.
What the hell?
Comrade leader.
I see you found me a very interesting souvenir. Bring him to me at once.
Yes, comrade leader. For the glory of Matryoshka.
In the leader's heart. In conclusion to this undoubtedly illuminating speech, I will tell you, comrades, my greatest wish, that one day our nations will join together and march together in the one true direction towards a stronger state, joined together with Matryoshka.
Stop the program!
I thank you, comrades, for your attention, and I wish you a good day. There's always plenty of time. That's Mr.,
This is an outrage, Mr. Kowalski.
Thank you. I mean, I know political discourse can become disagreeable, but to throw perfectly good fruit at a man for his views is an unconscionable breach of common courtesy.
I was talking about your presentation. Now then, please get out and never come here again. Ah, one more thing. We'll send you the cleaning bill.
What? Well then, I'll expect you to deliver the tomatoes with it. I'll make ketchup.
Goodbye.
Five, 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 four, three, five, seven.
Hello?
It's me.
Evan, get out of there and come back home before you get hurt.
Okay, Mom. I'm on my way back now. Bye. Don't stare at the gorgeous, mysterious stranger. Don't stare at the gorgeous, mysterious stranger. Don't... I've been staring this whole time, haven't I?
Wonderful presentation. The Matryoshkin authorities are impressed with your work. As am I.
Thank you, Miss,
I'm Anna. Anna Iglov. Someone will contact you once you get home. In case of any emergency, this envelope will help you contact me. We'll meet again soon, Comrade Haven.
Anna, authorities, envelope. Wait, what? An envelope with the instructions that Anna gave me tucked inside. I'll do that at home. Right now, I want to get out of here. Five, 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 four, three, five, seven.
Hello?
It's me.
Evan, get out of-
Okay, bye. That's the door. It's all-
Oh, you're back. How did it go?
It went great. Well, up until I started. Then everyone just laughed. As usual. Oh, by the way, some tomatoes should be arriving soon. So, that's something.
Oh, you had a call from Matryoshka. Your mother memorized the number. They said you should call them back.
Oh, one more thing. You remember that record, the Sandwich March?
Yeah? What about it?
I've decided that... Since I'm a man now, I'm too old for that kind of music. I gave it to the cab driver as a tip.
You... That was a rare limited edition pressing. It was worth hundreds of dollars.
Oh. I see. Huh. Really? Well, a man's gotta do what a man's gotta do. And this man just lost hundreds of dollars.
Well, I suppose just don't worry about it. And chin up. You were great on TV.